What's up, BC? This is Brad from H2Vinyl. This is the second part to the contest winnings from Andrew's contest, Broad Strokes Contest. I've got a lot of stuff here, 8 albums. I'm going to be doing like 24 needle drops, so 3 per album. Want to get right into it, so here we go. This is the first, these are in no particular order other than what I've, the order that I listened to them. So right off the bat on this video is Endless Boogie. This is their third album, released in 2008. Gosh, that print's getting really small. This is their third album, Focus Level. This made, I think it was 28 in Andrew's top 100 list. A little bit of avant-garde, a little bit of blues rock, and also psych rock. I have it labeled under psych rock, but they really do have that almost blues rock drone really down. And these songs can go on for a while. I've listened to this a couple of times. First time that I listened to this, I thought the songs were too long. But the second, third time that I was listening to it, two or three times, I don't remember. I liked the length of the song. The lead singer, I don't know his name, but it's almost like he has Tourette's. And so he can just blurt something out, like a guttural sound. Almost sounds a little like a Muppet. Really enjoyed this album. This is a repress, the 2016 repress on the No Quarter label. It's total length is 88 minutes long. And so it's on 2 LPs, of course. I'll be playing 3 songs from this. Smoking Figs in the Backyard, Gimme the Awesome, and Jammin' with Top Dollar. Those are the 3. And here are those needle drops. So this next one is the one that I'm most familiar with in this lineup, and this is Thin Lizzy, Vagabonds of the Western World. Let me get that in there. This was, I think, number 60 on Andrew, your top 100, and soon after you started doing these top 100 videos, you did those top 100 videos, I started listening to your top 100, and this is one of the first ones that I listened to, and because I had seen Thin Lizzy around but never really listened to them, and so I figured, hey, if it's on your top 100, I should probably listen to it. And so started listening to it, and I loved it. And I've listened to it so many times in the car, just driving around. And so I was very familiar with this album when I got it. I do not have a copy of this in my album until now. And so this is in 1973. This is a repress. As far as I could tell, it's the 1974 Waldo pressing on London Records, so it's got the London label. London label. Man, blues rock, a little bit of hard rock in there too. One specific thing that I loved about this album, and I think I listened to this album before I continued on with the Dark Tower series by Stephen King. The hero and the madman, they kind of remind me of the ending portions of the Dark Tower. You have the hero that he isn't on a horse. Well, at times he is in the series, but he isn't on the horse. He usually walks. But you find him in the desert, and he's walking the desert. And so the talks about that, and the madman is climbing a tower, and the hero, the woman, is in the tower, and he has to get to the top of the tower. And not giving you anything away of the Dark Tower series, obviously there's a tower in it. There is a madman, and the madman is in a tower. That's all I'm gonna say. And there's kind of a bout between the hero and the madman toward the end of the book. So I'm gonna be playing Mama Nature Said, which is a really great song. The Hero and the Madman, which is kind of a narrative song, and then Gonna Creep Up on You. So these are the three songs I'll be playing off of this album.
Steeple spire.
Go higher! Go higher!
Set the crowd from down below.
But the world's on fire.
Set the madman from the steeple spire.
I'm gonna creep up on ya.
Album was really happy, but at the same time nervous to see it in the contest winnings. This is Van Morrison's Astral Weeks, and this is number 7 on Andrew's top 100. And the reason why I was nervous seeing this is because I knew I was going to be doing a video on this, and I didn't particularly care for this album.
What? Oh gosh.
I said it. Listen to it. No, hold on. Wait a second. I listened to it in the car. And I think it was Orlando traffic. When I'm driving around, I tend to listen to things that kind of match the pace of everything around me. And this doesn't do it. This is acoustical. This is folk rock. This is originally a 1968 album. Wasn't certain the pressing, so I couldn't tell that. Also looks like a hair there. Weird. It's probably mine because I got long hair now. Let's see. Oh, let me finish that story. But once I listened to this on vinyl and was able to just slow down, first playing through this, second playing through this, really, really appreciated this album. And so while I may not pick it out every time that, you know, every chance that I get, still I really enjoy for what this is. And Van Morrison, incredible artist, incredible singer. What songs will I be playing? Astral Weeks. Was it Beside You? And Sweet Thing. I think those are the three that I did. So, if not, they'll be on the screen during the needle drops, the title. So, here is Van Morrison's Astral Weeks.
On a blue ocean against tomorrow's sky, and I will never grow so old again. And I will walk and talk in gardens all wet with rain.
Continuing on with the acoustic theme, we'll go with Jim James. This is a tribute to T-O, not T-W-O or T-O-O. 2009 album. This is a reissue, 2017 reissue. Like I said, acoustic or folk rock. Not really sure why I showed this one out of order, because last video I showed a tribute to number two. But I listened to him that way, and that's what I went with. I think I like the other tribute to more. This is still really good. The one thing that really stood out to me on this one is he uses a lot of reverb in this one, and a little too much. Actually a lot of too much for me. But I'll play some of I think I played My Sweet Lord, Ballad of Sir Frankie Crisp, and I forget what I think Slim Slow Slider is the last one. So these three songs, that last one I may be wrong, but you know, it's kind of difficult. I did 24 needle drops, so it's kind of difficult to keep track of everything. But here are those needle drops.
I'd be sad and blue if not for you.
Pass away. moving from acoustic to jazz, specifically bop, and this is Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. Moanin' is the name of this album. Technically, I believe this album was not named, but the first track is named Moanin' and it was dubbed that name. 1958 was the original release. This is a reissue, though I couldn't tell specifically what version of the reissue this was. It's on the Blue Note label, number 4003. I don't have a whole lot of Blue Note, and so I'm really, really, anytime that I'm able to get a Blue Note, especially if it's a gift, I've got two or three that have been gifts now, so thank you guys. Yeah, I really like Art Blakey. I think I've mentioned this before that I learned playing the piano, and so I have a few years of playing the piano between second and fifth grade. But in fifth grade, I started playing the trumpet. Really wanted to play the drums, and parents didn't let that happen. So for some reason, they thought the trumpet would be softer, quieter. Not sure what they were thinking on that one. But anyway. Really enjoyed Art Blakey, hands down. It rivals Thin Lizzy album. Thin Lizzy is just a little bit more familiar to me. But anyway, let's get into the Needle Drops, Moanin', which is the title track, and then the Drum Thunder Suite, and then the last one is Come Rain or Come Shine. So these three songs. And here they are. So, Andrew, when I opened up the contest winnings and saw this in the second box, I was really excited to see this, and I've never heard anyone or any album from this group, and knew that it was high on your list, and I just wanted to real quick show what one song I've heard from this group, and this is off of the Judgment Night soundtrack. This Judgment Night soundtrack was 91, 92, something like that. And the person, or the group, was Mudhoney. I don't know if you can see that. It's behind my label now. There we go. Mudhoney. And I know Mudhoney is a big, big grunge era. I remember seeing Mudhoney, but I know you enjoy Mudhoney, and so when you put Super Fuzz and Big Muff in the contest winnings, I knew this meant a lot to you. This is top 10 in your top 100, and for some reason I thought this was an album, like this was a full-fledged album, but this is more of an EP. And so this is originally 1998. No, I think I got that wrong. I don't know when was this released? 1988, sorry. 1988. Gosh, that first eight looked like a six. So I was like, 1968? I think I got something wrong here. But no, 1988 originally released, and this is 2009 on gray marbled vinyl. I really, really enjoyed this. I played the Sir Mix-a-Lot and Mudhoney for the opening just because it was the only Mudhoney track I had before this, and I thought you'd enjoy it because it was Mudhoney, not necessarily because it was Sir Mix-a-Lot. But I really, really enjoyed this, and I think I tried listening to some Mudhoney, but didn't make it through all of it. I don't know why. But yeah, like I said, grunge, alternative rock era. What songs did I play off of this? Mud Ride, No One Has, and If I Think, I believe are the three. So yeah, and this was stamped at RTI. Yeah, pretty cool. So here are those three songs by Mudhoney. Take you down to the dirt, drag you through the mud, drag you through the mud, drag you through the mud. Got a trip for two on a one-way ride. Take you anywhere, there's no place to Two more albums left in this video, and this next one is moving on to funk, and this is Bette Davis's debut album, 1973. If you don't know Bette Davis, you'd know her husband, and that was Miles Davis. This is an original copy on Just Sunshine Records label. There it is. That's the best I can do. I did have this in my collection, not an original. Really awesome to have an original. Really enjoyed it. I think I enjoyed it more than the one that I have. But the one that I have is, I got this. I was a member of Vinyl Please for almost 2 years and no longer a member. This was released July 2017. Listened to this a couple of times and I don't know. I enjoyed it. And some of the songs that I have down as favorite tracks, I have even more on this. Either I wasn't in the mood for funk that day, so I was in a funk for funk, I guess. I like the original copy a whole lot better than the repressing, which is very possible. Love this album. Like I said, it's an original, so thank you. I know how difficult. I know they are difficult to find nowadays. What songs do I play off of this? If I'm lucky, I might get picked up. Anti-Love Song and Game is My Middle Name. So these are the three songs that I'll be playing from Bette Davis's debut album. Here they are. Say you will, say you will. Just might get picked up.
as hard as I'd fall for you, boy. Well, you know you'd fall for me harder. That's why I don't wanna love you. Cause I know what you do to my heart.
Album for this video moves to blues, and this is really high on your top 100 list. It's actually in your top 10, and this is number 5 in your top 10, and this is John Lee Hooker's Don't Turn Me From Your Door. I know I've tried listening to this, and mainly listened to Spotify and could not find this on Spotify, and I just didn't pull it up on YouTube and listen to it that way. But really, when I realized that John Lee Hooker was pretty much doing everything, I had a great, great appreciation for this album. And so good. Electric blues, you know, some soul there. 1963 album. This is the 2013 Friday Music Label. Yep, Friday Music Label. Kind of a 180 grams, so it's kind of an audiophile. Just very clean sounding. And like I said, when I realized John Lee Hooker was doing everything, man, I just admired his work. And two of the songs are instrumental. That I play, and those are Misbelieving Baby, and then, oh gosh, Talk About Your Baby, maybe, I don't know, and then the other one, the middle one, the middle track will be Don't Turn Me From Your Door, which is the title track for this. So here are those three songs from John Lee Hooker.
Got no place of my own. Living down here on Borderland. On Borderland. Ain't got no place to call my own. Don't turn me from your door.
Again, for the generosity in these winnings and for your friendship. I've really been enjoying these albums and kind of digging into what you enjoy, because I know a lot of these albums have hit your top 100 list. And I wished I could have gotten this video out sooner. I know I said every 2 to 3 weeks. This was probably close to a month. It was just the nature of December. And working a good amount, and I've got projects at home that I'm starting to kick into, and so yeah, that just just didn't happen. So I'm hoping, I've got one more video left. We have a, you know, an epic of an album. I kid you not, one of these albums is the length of a Dark Knight Blu-ray. You know, it's 2.5 hours long, almost 3 hours long. So I'll probably sit down and listen to that one just one Saturday morning or something. But maybe look for the third video in 3 or 4 weeks. Just again, holidays and whatnot, and I've got projects around the house. But thank you again, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this video. A lot of great albums, and there are even more albums to come. So please keep tuning in, and we will talk to you next time.